Subhadip Nandi sir, who has come all the way from Kolkata to share his knowledge with us. Mr. Nandi has graduated with economics. He holds a postgraduate degree in IT and management. He has over 20 years of experience in the financial markets. He was the director of a software company where he was specializing on algorithmic trading. Currently, he is fully into prop trading for himself. He also advises and deploys technical analysis based trading system for prop firms and HNIs. Mr. Nandi has successfully developed and deployed algorithmic trading solutions on MCX, which works on principles of technical analysis. Without wasting much of our time, I would like to welcome you, sir.
Who I am and what I do. Otherwise, what I'm going to teach you will make much sense. See, I'm going to take Firebird's name. At one point of time, we were in the top three in terms of volumes on MCX. This is a 100% prop firm without any clients. So we don't have any ads or anything. Now, the reason I'm telling you this is, when we started to make an algo for a commodity trading firm, that changed a lot of my trading. Why? Before that, like any technical analyst, I was very much into subjectivity. I was seeing indicators, I was seeing area waves, I was seeing overbought, oversold levels and everything. But whenever you're going to develop an algo, that's a rule set, there's no chance of any subjectivity in this. Any decision you make on the markets, whether buying, whether selling, whether stop loss, whether position management, has to have a single rule. In 2009, we successfully deployed, I believe I was the first Indian to do so, an algorithmic system purely based on technical analysis on MCX. In 2010, we did the same thing on MCXSX. They were never into NSE because of the transaction costs. At that point of time, if you remember, commodities did not have a CTG, neither did the MCXSX in terms of a transaction tax. So playing on 1 minute bars was pretty easy. Yes, and all those algorithmic strategies that we did, we never used to carry positions over time. It was within the same day. Then, if you are following algorithms, in March, February 2013, Power Market Commission came out with a guideline. And that had a lot of things to do to stop algorithmic trading. Number one, there was a CTD, so any fast moving system became useless. Number two, there were certain safeguards regarding exchange quota. That was also one of the problems. What we did was, we took a step back. That is, rather than playing on 1 minute or 5 minute charts, we went into higher time frame charts or maybe EOD charts. And my whole journey from 2008 to 2013, what I learned was, in markets, this is my belief, you might differ, complexity does not work. If something is very simple, so simple, that you can make a person understand with class 10 maths knowledge, that this is why this is a buy, this is why this will go up, and this is how you make profits, that will work. The more complexity you get into, the less it works. If you write a code with 4,000 lines and it gives you a buy, it's kind of a glorified calf fitting. You understand a glorified calf fitting? Degrees of freedom, if I have 2 rules and it gives a buy, it's good. 3 rules, my efficiency increases. 20 rules, I am the king of the world. But 20 rules ensures that all the particular tricks of the market over the last 1 year get caught. Being a guy from a background of economics, not finance, when we did economics honors in Kolkata, we were taught to write or answer each model in 3 ways. Once, logically. Why logically this works? 2, graphically. If you can draw a graph and prove it. And 3, mathematically. To prove that mathematically. Whenever you hear, this I'm telling you from my experience, that algo is consistent only of maths. If somebody tells you that, if you do not understand very high level maths, you will not understand why this system works. Trust me, 99% of the time that person is fooling you. He doesn't understand how it works. So you use a lot of maths to just backtest and curve fit the systems how it works. The system which I'm going to show you is absolutely simplistic in nature. That is, when you see this for the first time, you will say that nothing this simple can work. Okay. Something of this simplicity cannot work. If you are here, you have done a lot of technicals, area trades, CMT, GAN and everything. So this will be something very simple. And I believe the more you can change the price directly rather than a derivative, the more close you are to the action of the market. Whenever you make an indicator, you get 2 lines, you are 1 degree removed from the price. You get 4 line code, 2 degrees removed. If you have a 20 line code, you are 10 degrees away from the price. The more away from the price you are, the more slower you are to react to market events. The model we will do today is based on EOD charts. That is, on end of the basis, we have open, idle, close. That's it. Based on that, we will make a model which will trade on an intraday basis. Clear? You'll be trading intraday, but at no point of time you'll be using intraday bars. Because if you're seeing 5-minute bars running in front of you, it is pure noise. It does not tell you to buy or sell. If you're doing that, that's a totally different scenario. So we'll be using EOD bars and then try to predict what is going to happen on an intraday basis. Clear? Okay. Like this, design the system. You don't need to write it down. If you want, I can give the PPT. I don't have an issue. Okay. And there's no complex formula involved. I mean, this is so simple. If you don't write even a word down, by the time you get out of this road, you'll remember everything. Trust me on this. So first we will design the system, then we will test the system. Now, testing the system will involve some bit of statistics, because that will actually tell you how it is going to perform in the near future. We'll be using some statistical tools that this is my reactor, fine. Now, how is it going to play out in real time? Number three, we will use money management or position sizing, which is absolutely essential. Entry and exit is probably 10-15% of the system. And then we'll create the system in real time. Design philosophy is trade with the trend. All of you must be doing the simple line, trend is your friend and all that. So we'll try to determine what the trend is. Then we will enter on a price breakout. I will come to each of these points. We'll use a very logical stop loss, what can be a stop loss. And we will use money management for my position sizing. How much should I buy? Now, as a trader, I trade only on Nifty Futures and use INR. Personally, I'm trying to incorporate Bank Nifty, but these two instruments are taking most of my time. So if you ask me if this is going to work on a stock, yes. But first of all, any system which you use, even this, you need to use this continuously on one script or one future. You can't switch between futures. If you're running a back test, running it on Nifty Futures, okay. On Bank Nifty, okay. On Reliance, okay. But every day a signal is coming and every day you're jumping between stocks, no system in this world will work. So if I'm trading Nifty Futures, I will concentrate only on Nifty Futures. The results or the tests you are about to see are on Nifty Futures. There's a lot of reasons behind that. One of them is the options are pretty liquid. Now, hypothesis. If you have done a scientific method, every model starts with a hypothesis. Hypothesis is, if prices are in a trend, then a pullback to the main trend is temporary, and sooner or later prices go back in the direction of the major trend.